Attention, please, ladies and gentlemen. Now pitching for the Yankees, number 30, Corey Lidle.
He was an incredible guy, man. He always, we were just a bunch of kids in high school that dreamed someday we'll be in the big leagues, and he lived life to the fullest.
What a lot of people don't realize is that, you know, he was a baseball player, but at the same time, I mean, all the guy I could talk about was his family, his kid, and his wife, and I think first and foremost, he was a great father and a great husband, and secondly, a great baseball player.
He was a great kid. I enjoyed working with him, and if he did what he was supposed to, he could beat anybody. I mean, he came up a couple of weeks before we went to the Boston with the five-game series and pitched an outstanding game.
You know, he always felt like he was better than the hitter. You know, he wasn't blessed with a blazing fastball, so he knew what he had to do.
He was a poor man's Greg Maddux, was basically the scouting assessment out. And he came in here and gave us some big starts. I remember his first start at Yankee Stadium against Toronto.
You know, just from playing with him, you realize that what a great guy he was.
He really appreciated everything he was doing in his life, you know, his family, his passion for flying, his passion for the game of baseball, and learning. You know, he's a real intelligent guy, and he'll be missed.
Corey's one of those guys that, you know, he was easy to talk to. You could get along with everybody. You know, it's a tough guy to lose, because I think he's a great individual, and, you know, he offered a lot to this team.
I got a call from Brian Cashman. You know, the world stops, you know, when you think of how fragile life is and how shocking things turn out to be.
And you appreciate life a little bit more after you see that, you know, a great guy with a great family, you know, with a great future, you know, just like that, you just want to wait.
Was it Cairo?
It's just so tough to swallow. He really is.
I don't know who that guy was.
You know, we're going to miss him.
He was the head masseuse.
Yeah.